The next session is a discussion on the role of the banking sector in strengthening MSMEs. I would like to invite our first speaker for this, Mr. Rajesh Singh, General Manager and Zonal Head, Bank of Maharashtra. I'll briefly introduce Mr. Rajesh Singh before I hand over the stage to him. Mr. Rajesh Singh has joined as a Deputy Manager in the year 1990. Since joining, he has rich experience and worked in almost all important domains of the bank. He has also taken the opportunity to work as the branch head in the Western, North India, South India, and Central India. He has worked as an officer in administrative offices across India in various verticals of the bank and worked as a deputy zonal head of the national capital. He has a rich and a vast experience as zonal head, working in big zones like Bhopal, Chennai, and it's currently heading flagship zones of the bank, that is the Pune City Zone, in the capacity of General Manager. A warm welcome to you, sir. I would like you to take over from here.
Thank you, madam.
Welcome, sir.
Okay. Respected Joint Secretary MSME, Mr. Atish Singhji, Director MCCI, Mr. Prashant Giravanichi, Madam Manjari Desaiji, I was listening keenly to the talk of Mr. Atish Singhji. I know him. He has been on the board of the Bank of Maharashtra. I met him in Delhi also while working in Delhi. So I'm really thankful that he has deeply analyzed the problems of the MSMEs and what they are facing today and what the need to be done from various stakeholder side, especially banking. So, yes, of course, I will be covering some aspects related to aspect in that. Yes, of course, MSMEs are the backbone of the Indian economy, and they are contributing, MSMEs are contributing 30% of the GDP, and in terms of exports, they are contributing almost 48 to 49%. And almost they are giving employment to 11 crore people with units, and a large number of units are there, around 6.3 crore units in the entire country. And they are the around 45%, more than 45% they are contributing in manufacturing sector. So MSMEs, whatever if we I analyze, if we leave aside agriculture is the largest employer in that way, and agriculture and then large industries and non-priority that we see, then whatever the activities are happening in the country, they all are covered under the MSME sector. So there is a wide scope and a large importance is there for the MSMEs, and they are giving employment and generating a lot of GDP, contributing in GDP and giving foreign currencies also. So MSMEs, if we broadly see that, they have been categorized in various categories. Earlier, the investment criteria was basically based on the investment in plant and machinery. But later on in 2020, they have now included the criteria of turnover also. So based on that latest guidelines, now micro enterprises are categorized into wherever the investment in plant and machinery is up to 1 crore and turnover up to 5 crore. Same way in a small sector, it is up to 10 crore investment in plant and machinery and turnover up to 50 crore, and medium enterprises 50 crores in investment and turnover up to 250 crores. So in that classification, they have supported the MSME, and what they have done is that whatever the export turnover is there, that they have excluded from this entire turnover limit. And in classifying that criteria of investment and turnover, they are saying yes, as per that act, the turnover will be accounted for as per the income tax laws, and turnover will be considered as per the GST returns. If enterprises which is classified in particular category crosses a specified limit, or then based on the investment and turnover, they will be upgraded, or based if the downgraded based on their turnover and criteria. Yes, of course, we know that any activity that is covered mostly in the MSME sector. So in our country, most of the MSME units are not registered. They are in the informal sector. So they are working, they are contributing to the development, to GDP of the country, but still they are not registered. So government has made now made it compulsory so that they can be enumerated, and we can come to know which are the MSME units. That's why they have come up with the idea that they should be registered. So now on, these all have to be registered under this registration from 1st July, and existing MSIs as well as the new MSMEs are required to obtain Udyam registration, which is simple online registration based on self-declaration, and Aadhaar number is mandatory for obtaining the Udyam registration. And that's a good idea ki yes, all MSME units which are working, either existing units or new units coming up, they will be registered, and they will be also, there is a registration benefit also, what benefit they can derive out of it. If benefits, if we say, then there is a payment assurance benefit, as Mr. Atish Singh was referring. Yes, of course, some disabled disputes, disabled problems arise, but they have made a provision in that MSME Act. That one key benefits of the registration as an MSME unit is that in case of micro and small enterprises, the payment for invoices is assured within 45 days under the MSME Act. In case the payment is not made to the MSME units, within 45 days, the buyer is liable to pay compound interest with monthly rest to MSME on the invoice amount at the 3 times the bank rate notified by the Reserve Bank of India. So that is a very good provision, and that is a very good benefit for those who are getting their unit registered under the Udyam registration. And same way for government sector procurement also, they have made some provision. The government departments and public sector enterprises are mandated to procure minimum 25% of their requirements of MSMEs. Therefore, the registration gives an edge while submitting tenders in such cases. Other benefits provided by the government include scheme related to collateral free, guarantee free loans, that is under GTMSE, scheme for market support and export promotion, and concessions in electricity bill, disbursement of certificate, registration charges, etc. When we talk of dispute arising out of that, fortunately, I am also a honorary member in the MSME Facilitation Center at Pune, along with that additional joint director industries, wherein we are practically resolving disputes from the MSME disputes which are claims against the various companies and others. Every week that cases are coming, and some redressal as per the MSMED Act and that Facilitation Council rules that we are providing, and a lot of cases we are able to resolve through this act. So that's a good provision. And central government and various state governments are promoting MSME promotion schemes. Like central government has a credit link capital subsidy scheme, and then for collateral free loans, this credit guarantee fund trust for micro and small enterprises, that is there. And Prime Minister's Employment Generation Program. Besides that, so many other programs of the central government are there, and various state governments have also framed their schemes for promoting the MSMEs. So this is the support from the government side, what they have created, and that's a good infrastructure that they have there. But main problem, as also pointed out by C60, regarding the financing of the MSMEs. Of course, MSMEs, they have initially informal sources. Yes, some of them are having their own funds, or maybe some through their friends, relatives, or informal sources they were managing. But now with the coming up of the formal sector, banks, financial institutions, among them PSPs, private sector banks, small finance banks, NBFCs, digital lending, of course, that was referred by him, crowdfunding, P2P funding, and equity funding. And fintech and MFIs. There are also options, a lot of options are coming up, and what we see the trend is that because of these coming up options, the major role which banks were playing earlier, now that is being gradually being shared by other stakeholders also. So that is coming, and that way this debt market is widening, and that also needs to be supported through bond market, and that government has to create that. This is the answer has already mentioned about that, that some alternate sources have to be explored. So from bank side, a lot, all types of schemes are there. So far as Bank of Maharashtra is concerned, we have all types of scheme, project finance in the form of term loans, working capital in the form of various other fund based and non-fund based options depending upon the requirement of the units. That is already available with almost all the banks, and with our banks, these are the all schemes are there to support the MSME units, including the credit which we are providing to the MSME borrowers without collateral loans of 2 crores. That is being applicable almost in all the nationalized banks, and in some of the even NBFCs and MFIs, they are also taking giving collateral free loans that way. So that is a good thing. But what main problem what we face is that yes, major units, MSME units, they are not up to that standard. That is that thing where we made to play. They have we have to make them bankable. One problem which we face is that CIC credit rating. Banks mostly prefer the financing MSMEs which has a good credit history and track record, hence take the same principle and other CIC before funding. Units with high scores are preferred over low scores, and here again the some problems actually because some are not in the formal sector or some have some default history in the past. So that creates a problem, but of course there are the ways, and we are we as bankers are facilitating is that process. Then again a good system has been established in the form of CIBIL MSME ranking, wherein the, they have ranked the, based on the performance, repayment history and track record of the MSMEs. They have they are categorized from CMR 1 to CMR 10, CMR 1 being the best ranking and CMR 10 being the worst ranking, and bank prefers up to CMR 4 and 5. So that area that can in fact fasten the decision in taking in financing the MSME sector. Same way rating, many banks have their own limits that way. Some of the banks are taking external rating beyond 10 crore, or some are taking beyond 25 crore. So that credit rating, and what major problem I see in external rating of the MSMEs is that the MSME rating, there is no separate rating agency for the MSMEs. Normal the credit rating agencies which are doing for the large corporates, the same rating and same criteria they are applying for the MSME units, because these are the smaller units and they do not meet that requirement. So mostly they do not get very good credit rating. So that is one of the hurdle, and what I suggest, what I request these things is, yes, of course government should explore such a thing wherein the MSME should have a separate rating platform and separate rating criteria, so that at least MSMEs they can also get good rating and they don't have to be compared with large corporates. So that is one area, and these are the main things which we see in the financing to MSMEs. So that has to be facilitated, and so far as Bank of Maharashtra, we have all these schemes, but one particular scheme which I would like to mention here from Bank of Maharashtra side is that we have got one Mahaswagatam scheme. That scheme is very attractive, wherein we are giving finance to MSMEs at the lowest rate of interest, that is 6.9%. So and that's applicable for the unit which are scoring CMR 1 to 4 ranking, and based on that they are also given consistent in their processing fees, and based on that in their funded limit as well as non-fund limit and CBZ, everywhere there is a concession, and that is a very among the our MSME borrowers, they are finding it very attractive, and that way we are from Bank of Maharashtra side, we are trying to help the our MSME borrowers. And yes, when MSME borrowers, yes, India has to grow in that way in industrial terms, then of course these MSME units will have to be supported, and only then they can scale up in terms of maybe from micro to small, medium, then medium to larger in corporates. So that support government is also making effort from their side. From banking side, yes, of course we need to provide all these supports, and from government side a lot of other thing Mr. Satish Singh has already detailed, and he has all those schemes, and he has been providing that, just like he, they are also permitting FDI in MSME, for MSME also, and for industrial policies is of doing business, that is the central government's initiative that way, and they are facilitating MSMEs to come up in a big way, and they have put focus on ensuring growth of the domestic firms, and government launched the Atmanirbhar Bharat scheme, which has witnessed a significant push towards enhancing domestic industries through a slew of measures like incentives, subsidies and funding support. Underlying goals is to strengthen the manufacturing and export capabilities of domestic firms and industries so as to put them at the heart of the global supply chains. If India has to become a 5 trillion economy, then it has to ensure that MSME sector has to to be given maximum attention in the growth story of the India. So with this short brief, I thank the MCCI, Madam Manjari Desai and Mr. Prashant Galbi for giving me this opportunity to present, to talk about the MSMEs. Thank you. I thank all the participants. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. For the information of our participants, Central Bank of India, Bank of Maharashtra and SBI Life Insurance are our partners for the event, and we would be having in-person meetings scheduled over spread over the next few months, wherein you can directly come and meet officials of the bank, wherein they can talk in more detail about the products that they have, and they can custom make and help you in availing credit for your business expansion. Thank you so much, Mr. Rajesh Singh. I would like
to move to.
Yes.
Can I ask one question over here? Just, you know, one short question.
Yes, sir.
So, Rajesh Ji, just tell us, you know, you were talking about a separate rating agency for the SME. SMEA, as you know.
Yes, sir.
SME rating is SMEA is the organization that does the rating for MSME.
Yes, sir. But Samira,
the parameters are also customized to the needs of the MSME. Anyway, having said that, my question to you is that while we have a full credit function organization in this space, whenever the MSME unit actually gets a rating done from the SMERA, so and the rating it gets, and the rating which the bank's own internal risk assessment is, you know, providing. We have come across cases where the rating of the SMERA is worse than the bank rating. So the MSME doesn't go to SMERA only. How do you resolve this problem?
That is there, sir. Sir, SMERA was earlier doing the rating of the MSMEs. But later on, now they have changed their name and they have become, name is Acuity now, and now they are doing rating for even large corporates. So that's why what I told ki, yes, there is a problem ki they are comparing the standards of MSMEs with the large corporates, where the, these MSMEs have a disadvantage. So they are unable to meet that standards. So that's why they are not getting that kind of rating which large corporates are getting. Yes, of course, your question is how we are going to resolve. Every bank has a internal rating mechanism. And so far as our bank, you know, sir, up to 25 crore, we are not taking any external rating from any credit rating agency. And we have our own internal rating system. Based on that, we are assessing and we are financing the MSMEs. Yes, sir.
Okay.